towns fear they're at risk of being forgotten as they begin the mammoth task of cleaning up. The water that stubbornly lingered for days is now starting to disappear. But locals warn support needs to be there for the long haul or entire communities could crumble.
Sun shining, flood levels falling, but don't be fooled into thinking it's crisis over. A zip across the Hawkesbury reveals dozens of homes are still underwater, others cut off. Residents reliant on sporadic food drops.
We had people come and drop food and offer us food yesterday and we said no, because honestly we're one of the lucky ones. We're up high, we're just blocked off and there's nothing else we can do.
While everyone is happy to see water recede, right now it's actually hampering relief efforts.
Water levels today are making it a little bit awkward for launching our boats. We've had to source alternate launching locations as some are still underwater and others are inaccessible due to the low level of water.
On the ground, locals are doing what they can to clean up and to clear out.
We're what they call the Forgotten Valley, and we are, but we're self-resilient as well. We'll get there.
For residents and businesses, even once the water subsides and the clean-up really gains pace, they then face another costly headache. No insurance. They're either knocked back or priced out.
We've got no insurance. So whatever happens, it's on the back of community, hopefully some government grants.
Experts want a long-term fix, a publicly funded insurance scheme underwriting cover in disaster-prone areas.
There is going to be more premium increases coming down the pipe. And as I say, what that leads to is this tipping point, I think.
The Northern Rivers is already in the grip of a housing catastrophe after the entire city of Lismore was swamped.
We've still got something like 300 people in emergency evacuation centres at the moment. We can't just have a tent city.
The recovery will be a long-term process, so we will be responding to the needs as they arise with the community.
Our RFS heroes stepping in with this stopgap solution, helping deliver 120 motorhomes. Driving from Sydney to the ravaged north.
It's sort of humbling because you just can't put yourself in their position, you know. Just can't imagine what it's like to have nothing.
Also on its way, a fully stocked medical equipment van, now a temporary hub for local GPs left with nowhere else to see their patients.
And they'll be using this as their medical centre until their brick and mortar structures are repaired.
A long journey ahead for what will be an even longer journey to rebuilding.
Let's go to Michael Hammond now, who's at Wiseman's Ferry. Michael, some high-level support has arrived on the ground.
That's right, Sandra, and it's certainly needed here on the ground. The people here in Wiseman's Ferry have certainly had a very trying week, like all flood-hit communities. And I want to show you now, this is the view from one of the local lookouts. And as you can see, there is those blue skies, that sunshine that is hanging around, but also those mud-brown waters which are still swamping and surrounding a number of homes. Now, it's a view that the governor wanted to see for herself firsthand today, so she stopped by the area to inspect the damage, to help lift spirits. Her Excellency, the Honourable Margaret Beasley, speaking with volunteers and locals, and she really got a sense of what help is needed here on the ground, both now and into the future. Let's have a listen now to her observations of that remarkable community spirit.
So there's a lot of logistics that go into actually the recovery aspect of things. And unless the emergency services, who, as I said, are the volunteers, really know how to work all of that, then things aren't going to be done effectively. But these guys are just magic.
And it's support that's spreading right across the globe. The royal family has even expressed its extreme concern, sympathy and distress at what is playing out here in New South Wales. And with more rain on the way over the coming week, there is certainly a lot more to play out here. But residents are remaining hopeful. Sandra?